Welcome to Sesame Street.
Uh-oh, Maria. Looks like a customer's coming.
Hello.
Hello.
Can I help you?
Well, if you can help my toaster, you can help me.
But that looks like a brand new toaster.
It is. A brand new 10-second toaster.
A 10-second toaster?
Is something wrong with it?
Oh, there is indeed. I'll show you.
Oh.
Oh. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. There. See that? It only toasted for 9 seconds.
A 10-second toaster is supposed to give you 10-second toast?
Exactly.
But this is perfectly toasted.
Oh, sure. It looks all right. It even tastes all right. But it's not all right. If I wanted 9-second toast, I'd have bought a 9-second toaster.
Oh, you're the kind of person who wants things to work exactly the way they're supposed to.
Well, of course. What's wrong with that? Can you fix it?
Yes, of course. No problem. I'll adjust the timer, and you can have your toaster back in 10 minutes.
Good. I'll be back at 9:13. Exactly 10 minutes from now.
Let me get your name.
Percival Quincy, but my friends call me Mr. Quincy.
Mr. Quincy.
Maria, something tells me you better have that toaster ready when you said you would.
You're telling me?
Wait till you see this, Mr. Quincy.
I promise you, you are going to see toast in exactly 10 seconds from the time you start your toaster.
Oh, I do hope so. One, two, three, four, five... 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
It popped up.
Oh, perfect, Maria. You did a great job. My 10-second toaster is working just exactly right. Oh, let's see. Oh, that's very reasonable. Mm-hmm. Oh, you know, it really bothers me when things don't work the way they're supposed to. I like to have my breakfast at exactly 7:38 every day. And now I know my toast will be ready at exactly that precise moment.
Well, I'm glad to be able to help you out.
You seem to be a pretty happy customer.
Pretty happy? I'll tell you exactly how happy. I'm totally, completely, absolutely, 100% satisfied.
Hi, Mary. Nice day, huh?
Yes, I suppose so.
What's the matter? You don't sound very happy.
No, I've been feeling a little lonely. I miss my lamb. He does not follow me around anymore.
Oh, gee, it must be hard not having him following you around anymore.
No. I mean, I'm happy that he has his own life, but sometimes I wish he'd come back.
You know, it was kind of cute the way he used to do everything you did, too.
Oh, yes. I mean, like, if I'd jump, he'd jump.
Aye, like that.
Yeah. And if I'd yawn, he'd yawn. If I'd stamp my feet, he'd stamp his feet. Oh, you're really good at this, Maria. You're really good. I know. Why don't you follow me around, Maria?
Oh, no. I couldn't do that. See, I've got a lot of work to do.
Ah, you're right. You cannot follow me around. I'll follow you.
No, wait. No, now, that's not such a good idea. But I think we're going to do it anyway.
Oh, Mr. Hanford, look who's coming this way.
I don't think I know him.
Well, his name is Mr. Quincy, and boy, is he picky.
Oh, 11:57. Only 3 minutes to lunch. Huh, that looks like a good place.
Oh, I bet he's gonna have lunch here. Boy, are you in for it.
I'm sure I can handle it. Yes, sir. What can I get you?
I'll have the foot-long hot dog, please.
Coming up.
Oh, I'm so hungry. It's been a busy, emotionally exhausting morning.
There you go, sir. 1 foot-long hot dog.
Oh, well, we'll just check it out.
A ruler?
No. Oh, would you be kind enough to look at this and see for yourself? This is not a foot-long hot dog. It's only 11 and a half inches.
Gee, you know, it's supposed to be 12 inches, Mr. Hanford.
Mm-hmm.
And you want your money's worth.
Exactly.
Okay.
Oh, dear, it's really the hot dog maker's fault, I suppose.
Hmm.
There you go. Hmm? I'm sure this is long enough to suit you.
I think you will just check that out and... oh, my. No, look at this. Oh, this is longer than a foot. This is 13 inches long. Oh, no,
well,
no.
I'll throw in the extra inch for free.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, you won't.
No. I don't want the extra inch, you see, because a foot-long hot dog should be exactly that. A foot-long hot dog. Not 11 and a half inches, not 13 inches. 12 inches, 1 foot. No more, no less.
Well, don't get excited now. I'm sure we'll find something back here to satisfy you.
Is it too much to ask for things to be the way they're supposed to be?
Go ahead. Measure it.
Now, this hot dog is exactly what I ordered. 1 foot. Yes, that's just it.
What's wrong, Mr. Quincy?
Well, the bun. You see how it sticks out over the ends here? I mean, a foot-long hot dog should come in a foot-long bun.
Oh. I told you he was picky.
Finished.
Well, I guess I'll be moving along now.
You mean you're not going to follow me around and do everything I do anymore?
No, it was a great pleasure, but I think I'd like to be by myself for a while. I hope I did not bother you.
No, not at all. It worked out great. I fixed a radio. You fixed a radio. I painted a chair. You painted a chair. I swept up. You swept up.
We did a great many things.
Mm.
Oh, but there's one last thing we could do.
You're right. Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters E and T and by the number 8. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Adios.
Bye-bye.